This is Brian Gregg. Just going to do a quick video. I'm starting a new video series on D3, data-driven documents, and I just wanted to give a quick overview and what that particular tool is designed for. And then in the next few days, I'm going to be putting out some screencasts on how to program with D3. But first, quick overview. D3 is also called data-driven documents. D3 is a JavaScript library. You can get access to it over in d3js.org. You can also, access it via CDN for inclusion in your projects. It is a front-end framework designed to work with your JavaScript and with data sets that you're importing either through CSV files, JSON files, TSV files, whatever particular data sets that you have to work with. The nice thing about this is that it integrates very well with your front-end applications. So you can pull the data in, you can set up callback functions that are going to wait for the data to be loaded in before you can start manipulating it, and then ultimately set up your visualizations to manipulate the actual components of your screen. So if you're working with HTML, you can change the width, height, color of different components on the page, but where it really shines is when you're working with SVG, because with SVG you can modify the attributes of your different components of your SVG image and do things like adjust line graphs or adjust bar graphs or make your content on the page update to reflect the data that is coming in from your source. You can obviously go through a lot of these examples out here. There's a lot of great examples of how people have used this to create heat maps and create different types of bar charts and maps and bubble charts and things that are showing data in a representative fashion. You can see there's a lot of interactivity here. And a lot of this is very reusable, so you can actually get data from different sources and pass them through to your graphs in a modular way. That's some of the things that we're going to be covering in this series. So if that's something that you're interested in and something that you want to start taking a look at, start using in practice, I definitely highly recommend that that you check it out. Much appreciated, and I will see you all soon with some fresh content. All right, thanks so much.